Hi everyone, my name is Mark Kwok and we're talking about my favorite things. Today we're talking about this guy. It's pretty gross and been used a very long time. Oh man, I should have made this camera ready, but this is the Dyson V6 vacuum. This is an old beast. I've had this thing for over 5 years and you can really tell it's beat the hell up. It's been through 3 moves with me. And this is the V6 version, which is fairly old now. But I wanna talk about just Dyson vacuums in general and how they've changed the game, in my opinion, as far as vacuuming goes. Back in the old days, I used, just like everyone else, Hoovers and those like, the floor standing vacuums. And Dyson also makes, or used to make, floor standing vacuums as well. They're big, they're clunky, they had those big filters and the big vacuum bags. Horrible experience as far as vacuuming goes. No one wants to vacuum, no one wants to deal with it. And then Dyson came along with these more cordless, smaller form factor, sexier looking versions of things. When these things came out, it changed how vacuuming was like no longer like this horrible chore, but instead a satisfying thing. So let me tell you a little bit about what's good, what's bad, just the whole experience of owning these sort of vacuums. I pull this out and vacuum the floors or spot clean in different various areas if I've like spilled something, probably every other day. So I'm using this 150 days of the entire year and I have not had many issues. The pros are this: they're extremely effective at sucking things up and they stay competitive. If they're not the best, they're probably right up there in terms of sucking power and being able to just kind of get things in different nooks and crannies into the vacuum. Second, the ergonomics are fantastic, I think. The way that your hand fits on the handle, there's a different attachment. There's like 4 or 5 attachments that come with each one of these. They're all ergonomically great and light, and you can take them in different places without feeling exhausted. I will also say that maintenance on this thing is not that hard. There's this thing, which is a filter. You can kind of release that. That's, if you can see right here, that's a filter. I bought a 3-pack. You don't have to buy the Dyson version. You can actually buy like the generic Amazon version that works fine with these. I think that's the only thing I've replaced on this thing. And Dyson, I think overall in the last like 10 years, Dyson has just been one of the best product designers out there. If you tried their hair dryers, which I think I'm gonna review at some point because I own that thing too. If you tried their heaters, their space heaters, even their lamps, like all of the things that they make, very, very razor sharp focus. And you can just tell that design comes first. Like product design, user experience comes very first. Now, obviously, the big con is gonna be the price. And I think that's the main detractor for folks. Like, do I need to pay this much for a vacuum? There's a couple ways to get around that. The first is refurbished. Some people are okay with refurbished, some are not. But generally the companies that do really high design things like, you know, Apple or Dyson here, their refurbished is up to a standard that I think is rock solid. Either you're getting something that is maybe used or has been returned or something like that, but they do a really good job of cleaning and making sure each part is perfectly aligned. The second thing is that I mentioned this is the V6. This is an old 5-year-old, 6-year-old vacuum. I'm having no problems with it. If this was really cheap and you can find it like refurbished somehow and like Dyson's still putting it on their eBay page or something like that, I wouldn't really have a hard time recommending these older versions too. Now, I'm sure the newer ones are much better, but these are still great. I'm still using it. I haven't felt like I needed to upgrade yet. So that's maybe a way to save some money too, because they have new generations constantly. So the V8 is now old. So maybe you can find one of those for a little better price. One extra con is I think these are more rated for smaller homes. These capsules aren't so big, right? Like this is all you got. So you gotta keep, and then the batteries aren't also humongous either. So in an apartment like mine, this just, you know, it's smaller, it's in the city, no problem, this is perfect. If you have a 5,000 square foot house, I think maybe you might need a couple of these or you need a different type of vacuum that has just that extra juice. So that is one con. I just, you know, maybe you're fortunate enough if you can have that con, but for me, it's not been a problem. But that I just want to explain that as well. So if you're in the market for a vacuum, you have not had an upgrade anytime recently, and you want to know what all this cordless stuff is about, I'm telling you, it's worth it and it's awesome. And the experience of vacuuming no longer is like this horrible chore. In fact, you kind of want to use it just to like make yourself clean, and like it's so easy and ergonomically good. All of those things contribute to a better experience, and that I think pays itself off easily. So Dyson V6, V8, V10, V11, whatever your budget can afford, I would get one of those cordless ones ASAP and get yourself a clean home. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Mark Kwok. I will see you guys on the next one.